we are going to do all about reading. So again, this is Amrit Parkour, and so let's talk about IELTS reading review. So basically, in reading, there are three passages, okay? Passage 1, passage 2, passage 3. And all in all, there are 40 questions, okay, out of which you will be marked. So basically, minimum 13 questions are there in every paragraph, every passage, but one of these would be all 14 questions. Then only it would be all in all. So all in all it would be 40. Okay. So now the next thing is that what type of questions actually comes in these passages. So as we have done in our plus 2 standard, like we do comprehension, like there is a passage from which we need to find the answer. So similarly, in the passages, you have a complete passage, a topic on which the information is given, and then there would be 13 to 14 questions whose answer you need to give according to this passage. Now underline this word, according to this passage. So always remember one thing, your prior knowledge can help you, but it doesn't mean that you should be trusting that only. For example, that passage says, the passage in the reading says that humans need carbon dioxide, but in our knowledge, by the fact we know that humans need oxygen to survive. But if passage is saying carbon dioxide, then that would be the right answer. So just try to understand the thing that in reading, prior knowledge can help to some extent, but your answer should be exclusively based upon the questions and the information provided in the passage. Okay, this is the very first thing you should do. Okay, so now let's talk about the types. Okay, so types of questions. Okay, the easiest type is blanks, or we can say fill-ups. Okay, but this is actually of two types. The very first is simple blanks. They will be like complete the sentences. But another one would be complete the summary. Okay, so there is different trick for both. So in the simple part, your answer would be in serial order. Serial, or you can say ascending order. Okay. So what happens in ascending order is that, for example, you have blanks from 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So for example, you got the answer of 7th because here there was a date like 1992 or 3. So something written like this. So it is easy, obviously easy to find the location of question number 7. So it would be like a very good sign for you. It means that question answer of 5 and 6 would be from that location, from the location of 7th, above that, okay? And 8, 9, 10 would be below the location of question number 7. So answers would be definitely in order, okay? This happens in case of simple blanks. But when it comes to summary, if it is written on your sample that it is a summary, then you must know that, no doubt, there will be possibility that answer would be in ascending order, but there is also a possibility that answers are in zigzag motion. Like answer 9th could be first and first could be at the end. So in summaries, these things happen, because summary means it is actually a summary of the huge passage. So information could be taken from anywhere. But definitely first go with the ascending things. If you think that answers are difficult to find, then just go randomly. Find proper keywords, and according to keywords, then find locations, then find answers. Okay. So this is all about blanks, and you can say fill-ups, and this is further like this. Okay. So I hope that now you will be able to solve your blanks. Okay, so I would like to suggest that you must go according to types. Like firstly, you should do only blanks. Then you should shift to the next type. So next types will be, I will be discussing in the next video. Okay, thank you. Nice. Have a nice day.
Okay.